The Day of the Dead Festival at the Old Vic Tunnels is a four-day celebration. It is an attempt to sort of bring the traditional cultural aspect of Day of the Dead to Britain. You know, the idea of celebration, the idea of the macabre, the idea of life, and obviously the idea of impermanence. But doing it in a way that would take the audience on a journey, in a sense, that would be curious more than anything.
We opened the first Wahaca restaurant about 5 years ago, and really ever since we opened, we were very keen to put on a Day of the Dead festival. There's a real strong sense of celebration and a celebration of life that we really kind of felt close to and that we really wanted to promote.
Día de Muertos is a very special day in Mexico because it's one of the things that is a Mexican hold to it as I guess as a sense of identity. It is a beautiful party, it is a beautiful tradition, even though it's the death, it's full of color and music and flowers and really nice food. So it was a celebration.
It's a very rich, rich cultural kind of heritage, celebrating life and death simultaneously. We decided to sort of bring a mixture of art, be it performance, music, film, installation, photography, and sort of fuse it all together.
The piece I'm working on is a boat. It's called, a boat piece, it's called Adrift. And it's essentially about crossing over an imaginary body of water from life into death. But I also envisage it as a kind of a boat which is lost up some river in the middle of the bush somewhere or the other. So it's a bit apocalypse now, I suppose, going up a river and the end journey is entering into death. So the whole point of the piece is that people get inside the piece and sit in there and they interact with the piece. They sit there and they become the person making this journey. Hopefully not for many, many, many years to come, but it's just an imagination about what this journey will be like.
You know, the last thing my father asked for before he died was a bourbon. I thought that was cool. I won't be happy about it at all. Dying. Well, probably my last words will be, oh, fuck. I didn't finish. I haven't done what I wanted to. You know, that's the truth. I think I've used the symbolism of death, and of course I've done the twist in it. For example, I've made an urn that is rest in peace. And I looked at the urn and I thought, that's just a bit like an ashtray. And of course, an urn holds ash. So therefore, I bought one of those plungers that you put your cigarette on. It fit perfectly. I mix up those two ideas together. I think you'll smile at it when you see it. Then there's the donkey, which is made of thousands of dead people. But not skeletons, they still have their hats and coats on. And it's just reminding you to look at things differently.
Me and Rodrigo, we got invited to play here at the Old Vic Tunnels, Day of the Death. So it's fantastic for us because we know this is a very special place in London. We're thrilled to be here because it's a very spooky place to play. It's very historical. It's like some sort of Jack the Ripper fucking scenario, you know? So it's perfect for the Day of the Death.
We'll be right back. think the Day of the Dead Festival, the Mexican festival, is a really good idea to bring people in touch with death, because it's a common, well, the most common factor in life is death. We've kind of incorporated an idea we've been playing around with for a while, which is exquisite corpses, the old game, surrealist game, where you each draw different elements, but we've brought it onto animal spirits.
They're kind of, they're something that came from the 30s, a Mexican guy who had a crazy dream.
Like a feverish dream, and he saw these animal spirits. It will be a nice visual thing that goes with the music.
It's quite fun, like taking these really small off-the-cuff drawings that we did really quickly and blowing them up into these like monumental, crazy sculptures.
In my family, we got that. My mom used to put the altar with all these photographs from ancestors, and my ancestors, they all drank, so we had to put all the things they liked when they were alive, like all this tequila and mezcal and loads of cigarettes and just crazy things.
Cultural richness of all these artists and the fun of the music and this idea that everyone could come and just enjoy that heritage really made the festival just brilliant for me.
Growing up in Guyana, I do remember when my mother died. When I came back here, nobody would talk to me. I was like cut out completely. Whereas in Guyana, it's like, hey man, I'm sorry, and stuff like that. And then the stories would start about her and stuff. And that is the thing about the Day of the Dead in Mexico, which I think is, we don't have here at all, basically, you know. It was a sad event, but it hadn't been put under the carpet as this embarrassing thing, you know. Very, very different attitudes, and I think their attitude in Mexico is way more healthy.